As girls, they were awkward and peculiar, wept in church, or refused to go at all. Their mothers saw right away no man would marry them. So they must live at the sufferance of others, timid and queer as governesses out of Chekhov, malnourished on theology, boiled eggs, and tea, but given to outbursts of pride that embarrass everyone. After the final quarrel, the grand renunciation, they retire upstairs to the attic or to the small room in the cheap off-season hotel and write, "Today I burned all your letters," or "I dreamed the magnolia blazed like an avenging angel, and when I woke, I knew I was in hell." No one is surprised when they die young, having left all their savings to a wastrel nephew, to be remembered for a handful of minor but perfect lyrics, a passion for jam or charades, and a letter still preserved in the family archives. "I send you herewith the papers of your aunt, who died last Tuesday in the odor of sanctity, although a little troubled in her mind by her habit, much disapproved of by the ignorant, of writing down the secrets of her heart."